Hi friends, I am James, one of the senior faculties of IBS, a premier institute for bank coaching and SSB examinations. In this video, I would like to mention about some important concepts of bond. What is bond? It is a debt instrument. Any firm, suppose they want to start a business, they need capital. So the capital comprises of two components: on their own fund, second, borrowed fund. So own fund or own capital we call equity, and borrowed capital we call debt. And this bond comes under the debt capital. Therefore, suppose it's a government which wanted fund, or a private company or an enterprise, when they require fund, they come out with an issue of bonds or debenture. Debenture and bonds both are almost same nature, because earlier the term bond was used by government and government organizations, and private firms they use debenture. Now even private firms also come out with issue of bond. Now here, what is the major difference between this borrowed capital and equity capital? The major difference is, in the case of equity capital, the investor becomes an owner of the company. Whereas in the case of bond or debenture, an investor becomes only a creditor, because he is giving fund to the company. So company becomes the debtor and the investor becomes a creditor. And again, the return on the bond is fixed. Whereas in the case of equity, it depends upon the profitability of the firm. Suppose the firm makes a profit, good profit, they come out with a dividend of say 10%, 15% or 20%, 25%. At the same time, if there is no profit or the company is incurring a loss, that particular year, company may not declare any dividends. Though the investor who has invested in the equity, he will not get any return. Whereas in the case of bond, they get a guaranteed return. When the company come out with an issue of a bond, they will mention this bond, the interest is payable is 10% or 8% or 6%. So that is a return for the investor. So in the case of bond, the investor gets a guaranteed return. Whereas in the case of equity, there is no guarantee. Another point, the bond can be either secured or unsecured. In the case of government bonds, naturally it is secured, whereas in the case of private companies bond or the bond issued by private sector firms, it can be either secured or unsecured. That they will mention in their literature, they will mention it's a secured or it is unsecured. And again, another important difference between debt capital and equity capital is income tax treatment. In the case of debt capital, the interest payable on the debt is exempted from income tax. Whereas in the case of equity capital, the dividend which is paid out of the profit is not tax deductible. They have to pay income tax on that also. I'll make it very clear. Suppose there are two firms, one is A, another is firm B, and both the firm are working in the similar line of activity, and both of them generated a profit of say 10 lakhs in a particular year, and their investment is say 50 lakh. In the case of first firm, they have not borrowed any money. The entire 50 lakh is their own equity. Whereas in the case of second firm, company B, they have borrowed 20 lakhs by way of bond. So in that case, at the end of the first year, the interest payable on the bond, or the payment of, we say, coupon. In the case of bond, the interest payment we call coupon. The coupon payable on this bond comes to, say, 2 lakh. So this 2 lakh can be deducted from the gross profit. So total profit 10 lakh, 2 lakhs is exempted. So net profit is 8 lakhs. They have to pay income tax for 8 lakhs. If the corporate tax rate is, say, 30%, they have to pay for 8 lakh, means 2,40,000. Whereas in the case of other firm, they have generated a profit of 10 lakh. They have to pay 30% on 10 lakh, that is 3 lakh. So this is the difference in the case of income tax treatment. If a firm has borrowed of capital, then that amount, the interest payable on that borrowed capital, is exempted from payment of income tax. Whereas the dividend payable on the equity is not exempted from income tax. And then this bond, it is issued in the primary market. A firm has issued a bond, and subsequently this can be actively traded in the secondary market. So it is highly liquid and can be traded in the secondary market. Now, I will discuss about the important terms involved in bond. Number one, what is bond? It's a debt instrument. And number two, the term is coupon. What is meant by coupon? Coupon is nothing but interest payable on this bond. So in the bond terminology, coupon indicates the interest or the return which the investor gets from the bond, from this particular investment. Third is the face value of a bond. The face value of a bond means the issue price. Normally, a bond will be issued for an amount of 1,000 rupees or 100 rupees or 10,000 rupees. So the face value is, say, 1,000 rupees. Issue price is 1,000 means the face value is 1,000 rupees. And next is the maturity. A company, suppose a company wanted fund for a period of 3 years, they will come out with an issue of a bond for a period of 3 years. So this particular bond will be maturing at the end of 3 years. So at the end of 3 years, when this bond is surrendered to the company, company gives them the money back. So maturity means the pay period for which the amount is borrowed by the firm. And next is the redemption value. Redemption value means what is the value payable on maturity. Normally, the redemption value will be equal to the face value. But there are certain instances when the redemption value will be more than the face value, or it can be less than the face value also. Here, at the time of issue of this particular bond, the literature, the company will mention, company should mention, this is redeemable, this particular bond is redeemable at a premium of, say, 10%. And the issue price or face value is 1,000 rupees. What does it mean? It means that on maturity, the company pays 1,000 rupees plus 10% of 1,000, that is 100 rupees, as we can say premium. So it is payable at a redeemable at a premium of 10%, means on maturity, the company pays 1,100. Again, the company can mention this is redeemable at a discount of 5%. Face value is 1,000. That means on maturity, instead of paying 1,000 rupees, the company will pay only 5% less. 5% of 1,000 is 50. So the company will pay only 950 rupees. So the redemption value is nothing but the amount which is payable on maturity. Next is market value. What is the meaning of market value? Suppose a 1,000 rupees bond, is a person has invested. The maturity is, say, 5 years. The person who had invested can approach the issuing company only at the end of 5 years. Suppose in between, this investor wanted money. What is the recourse? What is the alternative? He can go to the secondary market. That means in the stock market where the securities are traded. See, in the stock market, he can go to the cap stock or some other stock market. See, we have NSE, BSE, like that. In that stock market, you can go, and there you can sell this at the market rate. So the market rate will be either equal to the face value, or it can be above the face value, or it can be below the face value. So that is called the market value. So if the particular bond is traded in the market above the face value, we say that the bond is at a premium. If it is traded at a discount, we say that if it is traded lesser than the face value, we say that the bond is traded at a discount. And in some cases, it can be traded at par. It is traded at par means equal to the face value. So these are all the important points, important terminology. And another term is also there, YTM. YTM or yield to maturity. YTM indicates the yield the investor gets till he holds maturity. Suppose a 3-year bond, a person has purchased it, he hold it till due date and he surrender it to the company and get back the money back. Then what is the average yield he gets? This is called the YTM or yield to maturity. Another term is the bond volatility. Bond volatility means how the value of a particular bond varies with respect to change in the interest rate. So that is called bond volatility. So these are all the important terminologies in bond. We will move on to different types of bond. What are the different types of bond? Number one is fixed rate bond. Fixed rate bond means throughout the period, the interest rate or the coupon remains the same. Next is floating rate bond. Floating rate note. Floating rate note means the interest rate is linked to, or the coupon rate is linked to a base rate. It can be repo rate, it can be treasury bill rate, or it can be some other reference rate. So if the coupon rate is linked to some reference rate, we call it, it's a floating rate note. Third is zero coupon bond. Zero coupon bond is a particular bond where no coupon payment. That means in between there is no payment of interest. We call no payment of coupon. Then who will invest in this? See, 1000 rupees zero coupon bond. If you invest 1000 rupees, suppose the period is say 3 years, at the end of 3 years you get 1000 rupees. Nobody will invest. And this zero coupon bond will be always issued at a discount. That means suppose there is a zero coupon bond which is issued at a discount of say 100 rupees. That means this bond can be purchased at 900 from the company. And a person who is purchasing this bond, he will get this bond for 900 rupees. He has to hold it for 3 years. At the end of 3 years, he surrenders to the company. Company will pay of 100 rupees. Company will pay of 1000 rupees. Therefore, he gets 100 rupees as interest for 900 rupees for a period of 3 years. This is zero coupon bond, how it functions. Then another category is high yield bond. What is high yield bond? High yield bond are bonds issued by those companies which are not well rated or rated below average grade or below investment grade. Because suppose the ruling rate in the market, interest rate is 8%. And there is a company which falls under below investment grade. And they are coming out with a bond. Nobody will invest because the company's reputation is not very good. It is not well rated. So what the company will do? They want money. They will rate, they will issue the bond at a higher rate. So if the ruling market rate is 8%, they will come out with an issue of at 10% or even 12% to attract investors. So such bond we call junk bond or high yield bond. Another bond is convertible bond. Convertible bond is one which can be converted after certain year. See, a convertible bond which can be converted to equity after 5 years. So at the time of issue of this particular document, the company will mention in the brochure that this is a convertible bond and this bond can be converted to equity after 3 years or after 5 years. So it is an option given to the investor whether to convert to equity or surrender it and get back the money on maturity. another is subordinated bond. Subordinate bond is one where the preference, the company, well, the bondholder will have a lower priority over other debtors of the company or other bonds of the company. That means if it is a subordinated bond and the company had a, say, lockdown or some problem, they have to wind up, then the first preference will go to other bondholders and all their amount is paid off. And if any leftover amount is there, that will be distributed to the investors of subordinated bond. Next is perpetual bond. Perpetual bond is one which has no maturity. That means it is lifelong. So a person is holding a perpetual bond, that means he has to hold it till he dies, till his lifetime. So that is, we call perpetual bond, there is no maturity. Maturity period is not there. Perpetual bond or PERBS. Another bond is a bearer bond. Bearer bond is a bond without name. So a person who is holding that bond, he becomes the owner of the bond. So there is no name. See, the currency note which you carry, say a 500 rupees currency note or 100 rupees currency note, this is an example of a bearer bond. If I hold it, it's my property. If it comes to your hand, you become the owner of that bond. So there is no name indicated, that is bearer bond. Then there are two more other types of bonds. One is puttable bond and second is callable bond. Puttable bond means the investor can exercise the put option. Put option means the investor, the person who is holding the bond, he can exercise the put option after certain period as per the brochure of the bond. So the bond at the time of issuing, the company in its brochure, they will mention this is a puttable bond and the put option can be exercised by the holder after 5 years. The life of the bond is 8 years, but the put option can be exercised after 5 years. That means the investor or the holder who wanted to give back to the company, after the end of 5 years, he can surrender to the company and get back the money. So he can exercise that option. It is an option given to the investor. That is puttable bond. Next is callable bond. Here, the call option is given to the bond issuing company. The bond issuing company can exercise the call option after certain period as per the brochure of the bond. So put option is left to the investor, whereas call option is left to the company which issue the bond. See, suppose when does this comes? Because suppose a company issue a bond of 10 year, period is 10 year, they have declared a rate of say 8%, and the company feels that the interest rate may come down. So in the market rate, if it is 8% and 10 year is the period, throughout 10 year the company has to pay 8% interest. So if it is a callable bond and the call option can be exercised by the company after 3 years, and when the company gets funds, they can exercise the call option and request all investors or all holders, you surrender the bond, we pay back you your money. And so call option is left to the bond issuing company and put option is left to the investor who can exercise the put option. Thank you for watching this video. I'll come out with another video later. Thank you.
If you like our content, do like, share, and subscribe.